This sequence explains the method for installing a typical modular hydraulic strut. Assembly of the strut commences by first using a certified two-leg lifting chain to offload the components onto a firm, level surface. Referring to individual configuration drawings, assemble the appropriate components for each strut in the correct order with the lifting points positioned vertically. Ensure that all mating flanges are clean and all bolts in every flange are fitted and tightened to the specified torque. They should be tightened in a diagonal sequence. A motorized shoring pump is used to expand and retract the hydraulic strut. Attach the two hoses to the inlet and outlet ports on both the pump and the strut. Then open the safety lock-off valve on the prop. With the pump running, the lever can be moved into the ram-out position. Referring to the technical drawing, adjust the overall length to within approximately 150 mm of the required span. Once complete, close the lock-off valve on the strut and return the lever on the pump to the vertical position to depressurize and remove the hoses. Attach a certified two-legged lifting chain to the most appropriate lifting eyes so that the strut is horizontal when raised, and lift the strut into position. With the strut still suspended by chains, operate the pump to extend the ram so that the top cleat hooks over the flange and the end-bearing plate contacts with the beam. Attach the hanging chains provided, wrapping around the swivel end-bearing plates at both ends of the strut, securing it to the whaling beam. If the strut is to be used as a knee brace, strut ends must contact shear stops or clamps attached to the whaling beam. Excavation can then continue, and subsequent edge protection and ladder access should be placed as soon as possible to provide a safe working environment in and around the excavation within which to construct the permanent works. Using a two-legged lifting chain to take the weight, attach hoses and set the pump to neutral, then slowly rotate the lock-off valve to allow fluid back into the pump. To retract the strut sufficiently to lift it clear of the excavation, move the lever to the ram in position. The pump hoses are temporarily removed prior to any lifting operations. In addition to being used to support Groundforce's hydraulic bracing equipment, the struts can be used to span between concrete capping beams or concrete slabs. They can also be set for angular raking or vertical propping applications. Please contact our technical department for site-specific advice. This video is to be viewed in conjunction with a detailed written user guide, which is available to download from our technical library found on our website.